definitely at Hollywood Studios today, and this video is going to do a small like rewind to the early opening hours of us actually getting in here, but that's only going to last like 30 seconds, and then we're going to jump forward to right now in the future. So you're watching the past, then the future, then the past, that some order like that.
But, there. Don't try too hard.
Yeah. Okay, let's go check out Hollywood Studios. Okay, so we made it in. It is like 6:30, 6:40 a.m. and it's still all dark out. Everybody's headed over to Rise of the Resistance, I think. Or at least to that area. Looks like there's a holding pattern up ahead. Everybody's being held up here right before the Chinese theater. You can see all the lights over here. Right outside the Hollywood Derby. And all the people lined up over there. So Crystal is a very fast clicker. She got group one. Check this out. Yeah, so yeah, look at that, group one. So we were very well prepared to just do Tower Terror and like go back to the room, but she got group one. So yeah, our boarding group was just called. It's literally like 7:03. So yeah, we're gonna do Rise of the Resistance first thing in the morning. We're waiting for this crazy madness to die down a little bit before walking over there. So we're all heading back to Galaxy's Edge. And it's just kind of an organized mob of chaos walking slowly there, destroying everything in our path. So last time we were here, there's construction walls up, but now it's open. So we get to check out Galaxy's Edge over here in Disney World. So there's a clump of people over here to where the entrance is, just waiting to get in like us. Okay, we're in. I'll probably stop filming for a bit, but now boarding groups 1 through 10. Let's go. So Rise of the Resistance was amazing. I now know why, you know, this whole land cost like $1 billion or whatever, because it felt like millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars were spent on that ride. It was amazing. I'll be talking about it later after I film some footage. As always, I don't like filming on rides I know I'm going to do again for the first experience, just because I want to be in it. So we'll review it later. So we're inside the Jedi Temple store. And it looks pretty similar to the one at Disneyland, if not exactly the same. Maybe, you know, one or two slightly off things. But yeah, they also have most of the same products as well. Moving on. The line for the Smuggler's Run is 130 minutes long. Like, wow, that is crazy. And from what I've heard, the rocks are darker over here, and I have to agree, the rocks are darker than at Disneyland. So that's another small difference between our Galaxy's Edge and Disneyland and Disney World's. The line for Smuggler's Run just keeps on going and going. Let's see if we can find the end. So the line for Smuggler's Run keeps on going and going into Toy Story Land over here. It is just crazy long. I think it's like 180 minutes. So a 3-hour wait. Wow. Now we're in Toy Story Land. It's raining though, so we're not really sure what we're doing. We're just kind of walking around, waiting for our fast pass of Frozen. So you'll have to let me know if this is new or not, because I don't know, but I think this is a Christmas decoration, because I don't remember seeing it last time. And it kind of looks like, you know, a fun macaroni wreath picture thing, made just for Christmas, so. Just for fun, we're gonna go check out the Star Wars launch bay. See if anything's changed in there. So one thing that did change was this change to Darth Vader instead of Kylo Ren. So that's kind of interesting. You get to meet Darth Vader now instead of Kylo. And of course you have Rey over here next to her speeder from The Force Awakens. So over in their cantina section, I don't know if this has changed or I didn't notice it, but looks like they have blue milk that you can pose with over here. It's like solid, it doesn't move off the countertops, but I don't know if that's new or not. So we're in a section where they have some new stuff. So I'm pretty sure that guy's new. All this stuff looks newish, maybe. But what definitely is new for the newest films, newest film, is all these helmets. Like, wow. That's from the Knight of Ren, First Order Jet Trooper, Jet Trooper Sith version, and Vic Girl's helmet. There's also some weapons over here. This is Rey's repaired lightsaber, Jonna's bow, and Zori Bliss's blaster. We also have this robot thingy. I think it's called D.O. So we're in the main square near the Chinese Theater now. It's definitely died down over here. There's not a huge swath of people over here. And we're headed over to Frozen. Let's check it out. Wow, so they let Fast Pass people in early here. I've never experienced that. Or maybe they're just letting everybody in because it's raining. Oh, here's the control booth over here.
Winter's a good time to stand and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a... when life gets rough, I like to hold on to my dream.
I was there to soften their fall.
This one learned that Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
This is overdue. Gotta look our best.
Woo. I've never been so nicely dressed.
We'll be hosting and toasting the whole night through as we ring in the season with you.
Jolly season's greetings here. I'm wondering what your family does at that time of year. Hi, shalom, happy solstice, tidings of good cheer. Do you have tradition things for that time of year?
Just to be.
Got out of Frozen. It's actually different than Shanghai. It's different than the first time we saw it here at Hollywood Studios. So that's kind of interesting. While we make our way to Slinky Dog Dash, I wanted to point out these other ornaments that they have. Oh my gosh! It works out so well. Here we go to Slinky Dog Dash. I love how they have a miniature map of the whole ride over here, where it just goes through, oh hey, this is what you're gonna see on the ride. It's kind of fun. And down we go! Ah, second launch. Going backwards. Light speed!
Here we go!
Woo! Okay, so we're gonna go watch Muppets Vision 3D and then we'll be back. See you soon. Okay, so here's what the Christmas tree looks like. It's over here in the lagoon. Let's get a closer look. So there's some Christmas ornaments there in the lake around it. And it's situated there on the island. It's got a whole bunch of creepy Santa ornaments on it though. Let's zoom in to see one. So here's one of the creepy Santa ornaments, and to me that's just very, very, very creepy. I don't think I've noticed this truck like crashed into the side over here. Probably just haven't been over here too much, but yeah, it's definitely crashed into the side. That's pretty cool. And here's Gertie over here with his Santa hat. He's breathing a little smoke right now. Ice cream. As we're heading towards the exit, there's poodles and poinsettias over here.